So we're gonna do that sign that says example again, but we're gonna make sure that we're doing it on beat. So I'll do four scratches, then I want you to do four scratches, and we'll do that a few times to get you comfortable. All right, so again, I'll do my four, you do your four. Here we go. As you test it out, you wouldn't be doing this in front of your crowd because they don't want to hear you test out your blend. All right, so let's try it again. One, two, one, two, three, four, go. There we go. It's so good, it's hard to tell which side is which. But I can use my crossfader to test to see if I'm on beat. Now let's take a listen. And the last tip I'll give you when it comes to mixing so it sounds really nice is that, and I'll show you this one, is that you can start with the bass of the song you're going to bring in all the way down, and then slowly bring the bass in of the song you're gonna bring in and turn the bass of the song you're bringing, the song that was already playing down. So you're kind of swapping bass lines. So then you don't have two bass lines clashing with each other. Because a lot of times sound systems can't handle two bass lines at once. So then you're just gonna have it sound a lot smoother. So for this example, we're gonna just do that really quickly. I got the bass of the track on the left all the way down. And I'm gonna swap them when I make this transition. See, already that sounded way better than the blends we did before. So using that bass swap technique, you can make your transition sound really smooth, and using the scratches that we've learned, the baby scratch, the chirp scratch, the transform, as you scratch that song in so you're keeping your song on time, you can add that to your sets and add way more creativity. So using all the skills we've learned to have some really creative and fun and energetic DJ sets.